So today we're going to be talking about a tool called Dots and the Brain. And this is a tool we can use with our clients in practice to talk around neuroplasticity and how new neural pathways are formed in the brain. This can be particularly useful if we're working with clients who have a history of childhood trauma and are experiencing really heightened emotions in practice, or if our clients are using alcohol and other drugs and we want to talk around how they can maybe make new behavioral change. So this is a simplified version of the brain. Pretty much I just scribble small dots in the brain. Obviously our brains are a lot more complicated than this, but this is a nice way we can describe to clients what our brains might look like. So each dot represents a neuron in the brain. These neurons can communicate with each other through electrical signals. And every time there's a connection between the neurons, a link or a neural pathway is formed. This diagram can be used as a tool in alcohol and other drug work to describe how these pathways are formed when moving from having a thought or a feeling to having a response. So when someone might be feeling a trigger, such as they might be sad or happy or angry, they might then respond by smoking cannabis or going off and having some alcohol. So we can sort of look at what's the thought or what's the feeling, the trigger potentially, and how does that lead to a response in the brain. So that might form up there and that neural pathway is formed. Over time, if that person continues to respond in that same way by smoking cannabis, the connections in the brain strengthen and the neural pathway can become what we might call a neural highway. So over time, becoming very strong in the brain, sometimes even getting rid of those other neurons around the neural pathway. The person might describe their response of smoking cannabis as automatic and they might not feel like they have any control over their use. However, we know that our brains have the lifelong ability to form and grow new neural connections, and we call this neuroplasticity. Through introducing the idea of neuroplasticity to our clients, we can talk about having a bit of choice. Adding in new responses to situations can mean that we grow and form those new neural pathways. You don't have to stop feeling angry, but what else could we do instead? So it might be sort of brainstorming some ideas and saying, okay, let's take 3 deep breaths together, let's do 5 star jumps, or let's go for a walk. So you're introducing new kind of concepts and new ways. You might find that other people will have their own ideas they want to try out, and it can be really useful when people are trying these things for the first time to be doing it with another person. Let the person know as well that at the start, when they're starting to choose or try different responses, such as doing those 6 star jumps or going for a walk, it might feel a little bit uncomfortable or even a little bit weird. Through doing something different, they're creating this new neural pathway. Over time, that neural pathway is going to grow stronger and stronger, and it's going to feel much easier and much more comfortable. And that one can be the automated response. And over time, the less pull we will feel towards the old neural pathways. So this is a tool that you can use with your clients to describe neuroplasticity and how we can continue to form and grow new neural pathways in the brain. It can be an awesome message of hope for when we're working with clients, as it can help them to feel like they can have more control over their behaviours. And it brings things back to that biological level, that it's not innately them that's bad as a human, but it's just, hey, this is our biology and the way our brains are formed. So give it a go.